Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We have a very interesting panel here. We have four panelists from very different categories talking with us today on whether they're still spending on TV the way they used to in past also. Is TV still first for them? And so before I get onto the topic, and we have had such interest, Sam sir and Shashi sir, they've shared so much insight. But because I also did some Google search, I must share the data that I got, which says that there was an eye tracking survey that said that TV commanded twice the active viewing of YouTube and 15 times the active viewing of Facebook. Connected TV ads show consistently higher completion rates, which is almost 95%, than desktop, which is 75%, and mobile, which is 72%. So with these, I mean, mine is Google search. You people spend lots of dollars on getting the real data. So from you, I would want to understand how much of this is correct. So if I can start with Karthik, how much are you still, like, what is your media mix? Like, how much are you still spending on television vis-a-vis digital or other mediums? In percentages, I mean, I don't want, sorry. I'm sorry. Karthik.
So I work with Pidlite now, and I'm sure all of you have seen a lot of Pidlite advertising. I think Sam had referred to it briefly earlier. A large part of what Pidlite spends is related to TV. We believe that it's very important as a part of our media mix. However, we've been experimenting a lot as far as digital is concerned. It varies by the type of brand and the type of TV that we advertise to. But on an average, I'd say that almost 60% of our advertising spends goes towards TV, and the balance 30-odd% goes towards digital and other facets of advertising.
You still have 10% left.
Well, okay. So somewhere over there, 75-25%.
Okay. Formally?
Currently, I'm working for RSS Global, and we are into the business of personal care. So taking your question forward as a media mix, yes, 60% is what we spend on television, roughly 25-30% on digital, and the rest around 10% on other mediums, to be precise. That's the media mix that we have.
Is it same for insurance sector?
No.
Not really. Because I think it is to be viewed from the segment that you're approaching. And the product, what is the best suited segment for that product? So I would say when it's a brand campaign, yes, television takes the maximum share of the wallet. But when it is a tactical campaign in terms of for a product, then you create a fabric between multiple mediums. So television could be one, along with digital and maybe an outdoor. Print has gone down, for sure. But the advantage of television, of course, you get a mass reach. So again, it depends what campaign you're doing. And to answer your first question, what percentage? So around the year, I would say about 35-40% goes in television.
35-40% on television. Much lesser than what?
Yeah, because as I said, it's dependent on the product and the segment.
Sandeep, for you? You come from bathroom solution, and it's consumer.
Good afternoon, everyone. See, I basically represent Jaguar, which is into bathroom and lighting category. So it's a mix of both B2B and B2C category. See, I'm sure everybody will agree, there has been the change in the mix. Percentages are not so important because it depends on a lot of other criteria. I think the larger agenda and larger focus should be there is definitely a drop in percentage. Okay. Obviously, the base has gone up. And where this money has gone, it has gone in digital, definitely. It has, in my category, definitely the trade magazine and exhibitions, you know, outdoor, definitely. So, there is a shift, and I can definitely say for my, my brand and my category, definitely there's about 10 to 15% drop. And
after drop,
percentage drop. So it doesn't mean, commensurate to the value, but there is a percentage drop, and for the valid reasons, because, today you have limited, like example, you have 24 hours in a wallet. You need to share it. So eventually TV was ruling the roost. So everything was TV. And you remember, I think I can vouch, you know, when 84 the TV came in and we have only Chitrahars and Yale Zindagis and all that, you have to be there. But now the case is not there. So what needs to be seen that where this money is going, and for the industry is very important that what is that led to the change? So is the affinity, is more a frequency, is more of a trust, more of a visual delight, more interaction, depends on industry to industry. But definitely there is a shift.
But despite the shift, what I've understood is, TV still continues to dominate.
Still have a lion's share. It still have a lion's share. In my category, about say 50-55% we spend on TV.
So it's more than like, she said 60%, me said 60%, for you it was 35-40%. So what is it that still makes TV the first choice? Anyone, you can start.
Okay. See, I think TV, especially for a category like bathroom lighting per se, straight away TV brings a lot of credibility. And that's any developing nation, anything coming on TV is supposed to be credible. That's a very thumb rule for that. A category which is like, which has been a very high involvement category, which is more of a visual delight, you have to be on TV because you can show a great bathroom there. Great. So you can evoke that kind of emotion in consumer that, oh, I want to have a home like this. I want to have a bathroom like this. You may not have the same thing on digital. Digital will give you a frequency. But TV give you trust for the factor because and obviously the biggest thing is the reach. The reach and the cost at which you can go repetitive, which is the frequency. I think to me the frequency, the reach, and the credibility which a TV brings in, I think to me are the three major reasons.
I totally agree with Sandeep. Despite that we have limited amount of exposure to television, but life insurance as a product is an emotional product. It's an intangible product. It's not something normally a buyer would experience. It's post him what would experience. So television gives you that flexibility in terms of creating that emotional connect of the brand. And when you're looking at mass audience in tier 2 and tier 3, as Sandeep rightly said, till date television plays a role where it looks more authentic and something which is being promised is a mass promise rather than digital, which would largely lead into a product or a tactical sale.
So what I've understood, it has trust and it has the ability to evoke emotion, right? So does that apply to your personal care sector as well?
I'll just take from what Sandeep has said. I think what all of us here are marketers. And I think it's one of the most interesting times to be so. Because I'll just take back to one thing. We've all gone through this theory of Marshall McLuhan. Okay. Where he, in his 80s, he was adamant at that point of time that does a medium have more effect than the message? I think the time is right for us to say so. As marketers, what we intend to understand is, what is the effect this medium has on my consumers? Okay. Now we're talking of television. We're talking of digital. Something that has been there in our life for more than 20 years approximately, and something which is growing. A small base versus a bigger base. So the growth rates, numbers, factors can always be there. But when we choose to talk about our product and the values or the brand ethos and all, we go by a couple of instincts. Like, is this medium and what is this medium doing to the consumer today? How is my consumer reacting to this medium? So when I stand today in a personal care brand, which is 5 to 7 years into this whole landscape of marketing, awareness is a big concern for me. And I know that if I'm using television, my awareness is the fastest, quickest, and the most credible. So that is my brand journey vis-a-vis the medium as of now. The top of the funnel and the bottom of the funnel. Now, had I been doing this 10, 12 years back, probably when I was moving into the set of consideration bit, my choice would have been to again filter out my subsets within the television viewing audience. Today, once the top of the funnel of awareness is done, while I want to build the consideration, I do have other mediums like digital where my sharper targeting can help me do so. So my brand journey vis-a-vis the condition of the current state of mediums and what my audiences or my consumers are reacting to precisely shortens the idea of me to choose and peg my money and my budget source. And yes, the mix is formed creating all these aspects in mind.
You want to add to it, Nathan?
My views, I completely agree with what Pauline had said. My slight, so I work in FMCG for most of my career, and I find that a lot of the work that we do as marketers leads to transactions that happen offline. Unlike a fin sector or any other sector, e-commerce for instance, where the bottom of the funnel becomes a very important part of advertising. And when Sam had spoken earlier, he had spoken about how we could use TV advertising to build more top of the funnel awareness, which is exactly what Pauline spoke about, and that's really, really important. Digital in its position is I see that as an advantage, and it's sometimes a disadvantage. Sometimes you don't want a sharp instrument, you want a blunt instrument. You want to reach much further, and we had a speaker earlier, Mr. Shivam, who was talking about how can we whisper to many versus targeting a few. I completely endorse that. And if you, I mean, again, Sam had spoken about the fact that in reality, only about 30% of your business comes from the core audience. The 70% who are flirting with your brand at every point of time. And when you do a media plan, if I was to do a digital media plan, I would say very specifically, moms of this age, in this city, in this town, so much time on this channel, I'm going to lose out on a lot of them. TV is a little bit, open canvas there. And I think a little bit of gray area, I mean, it won't fit into an exact science. But at the end of the day, as I think both the speakers earlier spoke, it helps move product and it helps bring in profits. And therefore, I don't think there's any way that that's going out of the media mix. I think as Sanjeev had said earlier, what Nipun had said, which is that depending on the type of audience and your marketing objective at that point, you'd probably put your pedal down a little bit more on digital or TV, but TV has a very important role in that sense.
So, what I've understood is that apart from other factors like evoking emotion and it has the trust and other things, also when as marketers, we look at measurements. TV is still far more transparent. Digital measurement still remains a constraint. I mean, so would you like to speak more about ROI and brand metrics? When you are spending on television, do you feel more as in comfortable in the sense that I know where my money is going?
Can I? Yeah. So I'm going to do a very shameless plug for Madison right now. All right. So, I used to be very scared about digital advertising. It's very fashionable to do digital advertising. I must say as a marketer, if you're not doing digital advertising, something's wrong with you. That's how everyone looks at it. So, yeah, social media, you have to do it. Now, a lot of times, if I'm being very honest, we've done advertising. I still feel marketers are getting their head around advertising. Most of us over here have probably grown up in our careers doing TV advertising, print advertising, outdoor, maybe even wall paintings at some point. But this particular tool that I recently discovered from Madison, which is, I think it's called TV Plus, which we had spoken about. I think it's a really cool tool. It helps you understand unduplicated reach across medium. They do it very well. I'm not sure whether the tool really is as effective as it is. But at least it gives me a single canvas in terms of how I can view the overall effectiveness of the campaign. And again, that's exactly what Pauline said. It's not about a choice of medium. It is a choice of marketing objective and what medium can deliver the best. And therefore, I feel that metric and if your reach and frequency and what you want, how many people you want to reach out to is getting met well, I think that's a very good tool. So cheers to Madison.
While comparing the ROI for the TV versus digital, see every media vehicle has its own robust mechanism, whichever level. So, like example, if I just start with digital, you can do a geo-targeting. Okay. Today, like example, in my category, what we have done, we advertise on digital. People come on the website or any platform, they click. From there, they come to the website. If they are interested in doing up the bathroom, I can create the 2D and 3D drawings.
Okay.
They walk into the store with their drawings. I push them to my dealer counters. I know that they have taken the address. They've called on the number. So there is an amazing amount of ways you can track digital. Definitely, if you see the recent BARC data, you know, the numbers have gone up now. The base figure has gone up. But definitely there is a challenge there because, you know, every week you can tweak your campaign. Digital, okay, has its own way advantage that you can on a daily basis, you can do that. So from a, if I specifically stick to the TV and the B2B advertising, okay, see, as far to me, there is nothing called B2B or B2C. Consumer is a consumer. And on TV, the fundamental is the TV has this great quality of creating a content also. Why should I go and watch a hoarding? Or why should I go and watch a TV? You have to be in a business of entertainment. You have to entertain people. And while they're getting entertained, you can send your own messages there. So if you, so that way TV has this great advantage. However, measurement comes from a, like example in my category, if your ad is coming on TV, the trade network is so happy. You know, their whole confidence level, they can really change the game. They're saying, oh, I've seen your ad on TV.
Yeah.
Boss, you are doing great. Yeah. His confidence level sets the, you know, tone itself. It doesn't mean that BARC is not there. Weekly data is analysis. I have a concern that though the numbers have gone up, but HDH numbers have not gone up in that order. So my concern is that if I really go to HNI customers, whether I go on a star HD or, you know, these HD channels, data is not much there. So I think BARC has done a lot in last, I would say in last 1.5 years. But definitely for a marketer, there's always a challenge that kuch kami reh gaya hai. Mujhe pura nahi pata. You know, there is a sense of a gut feel and anybody says I'm like, I've mastered the complete plan. I know where money going in. I think it's.
So being from financial services, ROI is the only thing we do. And unlike my experience of 10 years in auto, where I would experiment a lot of things, you don't get that flexibility in financial services. You have to be very focused. So when I look at ROI from television, as my agents start talking about it, when we do a customer research, if I'm coming into the recall, that's very critical for me. Because that can only come is through television. Where digital comes is, television is helping me to broaden the funnel at the top. But my net objective is bottom of the funnel, if it's a tactical campaign. So it always creates an impact over there. And they say, you know, if you keep talking about something again and again, and you build a perception about a brand, television does that role maximum. And through the brand studies and all, we have realized, it's not that digital is creating a brand impact. It's creating more of e-commerce for me. But television creates a brand impact, which my distributors, my existing customers. So when we do customer segmentations, we realize the confidence because our product is a 20-year, 30-year product. But when he regularly sees us on television, his confidence on the product that he's got goes up. And then one of the most important metrics in insurance is persistency. You pay your first premium, second premium. So as an organization, my bottom line increases when number of premiums go up. So is there a formula or something which can tell me exactly this is how it is impacted? No. But when I do my brand study, when I do my NPS, it reflects region wise where we were strong. My persistency and my bottom line is much better. So I think that's most critical. And that's something which I try and convince my CEO or my CFO. When I need the dollars, so I think that's what.
Then you should increase your spends, no?
Business has to increase that way.
For personal care,
so I heard Sandeep speaking, and that's exactly what I was trying to say. See, 20 years, TV, they're in our household, across generations, they're watching it. What makes it authentic? The way my consumers are reacting towards that media gives me the confidence to it. That's what we're trying to say. Now, when it comes to this whole idea of, so I often deal with dealers, distributors, and my consumers, right? And we're into a lot of female FMCG products, but my distributors and dealers are male people, right?
Yeah.
So I often have this question. So for example, if I have to talk to you about a female brand, let me just take one of the most common ones, say Lakme. None of my scope analyst would probably be using any product of it, but when it comes to the fact that whether they know about it, they may. How do they know about it? The first, this is typically from a brand perspective. What is the first step that a brand needs to cross? That is that I need to be known and then, of course, considered for the right reason. For us in FMCG, there are a lot of stuff like the retail space where you are present. If there is somebody who is endorsing that product there, the last minute shift in the purchase, like when you're standing there in categories with five competition, your packaging, your description, or somebody trying to influence you from back the counter, all this finally lets you take that final call of whether you're going to pick my product or not. But the first journey that as marketers we cover is to ensure that people know about the whole idea of what am I selling, what is it that I'm selling differently, and how is my product. That's the idea. And that's when a medium which is there in your life for almost more than 15-20 years plays a credible role. Now there are new age mediums which are coming in, which has to be explored for again. Why? As Karthik said, some of us, even though marketers often say this, if you're not doing social media, uncool. You still have to do that with the edge. So realistically speaking, it is the mix that we do. But TV for us, at some point of time, various categories that we play, the journey that we take with the brand in that category is important to be noted. It cannot be objectively in isolation and agnostic to the categories and the product or the services that we sell.
Naji, I'm conscious of the counter.
Yeah, I'm very conscious of it also because we have lunch after this.
Yeah, so we don't want people to be waiting. I'll just add one thing. Let's not look television as whether it's important, most important trust. I think everything has to be viewed. We all know data keep coming. 67% is single television users. But do we realize how many of them are passive viewers?
Yeah.
So if the family is sitting and watching one of the Saas Bahu serials, the father or the kids are actually either on the iPad or on the phone. So the consumption is linked.
Yeah.
So if you are there on the television and he sees you on the social or on the digital, there can be an immediate consumption. So I think that's very critical. And so a lot of mediums will go hand in hand. Not that one would lose an importance, but would go hand in hand.
So all of you said that the mix has changed in last few years. Now, when we close the session, I would want to know from each one of you how it's going to evolve further. Like, let's say another 5 years or 10 years. How do you see this mix changing further?
See, in the
because
context,
10 years later, digital also may have more credibility than it has now. You know, then you can't say that it's new or it's still evolving, or I mean, might still be evolving, but still it will be there for quite some time.
So, across the world, AI has taken a big thing, which is not yet prevalent in India. Again, we go back to the same thing. We as marketers, and the country where we are trying to sell, or the locally, whatever is the target geography, target audience, we have to keep watching out how are these people interacting with that particular medium. Every medium is going to work. Today, for example, television is growing at 66%, right? That's what we say. So has it stopped growing? No. There will be other mediums. There will be credibility that will brought onto the table. But the journey of a brand is always going to be decided from the brand's perspective by noticing that if my set of consumers and how they are going to grow. There is bot, there is AI that has already come in the world, which is not so prevalent in our country right now. But they are going to be, in the next 10, 15 years, that's also going to come in. We are going to always take that into account, that how my brand or my category or my consumers are evolving and reacting to that particular need.
You were saying something.
See, one thing is, I think there is over fixation with the medium. Medium has a limitation. It can work once or twice. But if you have a poor content, you can't blame, beyond a point. So I see the biggest advantage with TV is that it has those audiovisual quality. The TV screens are becoming better. Digitalization is having. The HD contents are coming. I think somewhere they have to really look into the content. See, if you really see what happened to the news now, I don't want to watch news. They're literally on the street, they're fighting almost like this. And post Netflix, see the quality of content there and the quality of TV is there. So eventually you're not buying into a particular channel, you're buying into a particular program. And within the program, so TV has to really see up the game in terms of quality of content. And second, you know, I see for, in terms of, you know, the placement. So like example, if I have a lifestyle brand and I'm putting up a brand in a certain environment, and if I see the ad before me or after me or the whole environment is not so conducive, I will not be able to build my brand. However, I see in the recent, in the coming times, the frequency builder will be digital for us. We continue to go on TV to build the imagery. Brands are made there. You can always have a higher recall comprehension because digital gives you brand comprehension. Digital gives you brand recall. But have to really build emotion, emotive part of it, definitely we have to rely on TV. So I think this is where TV doesn't have to get into the kind of a race with digital, with, you know, this out of home media or for digital or for, you know, any kind of an expo and trade magazines. Stick to what your medium is, which is like visual delight, good quality content, and try and find out innovative way by which you can get the brand integration done. I think, and then, so I see for my category that I will continue to be on TV to build imagery, aspirations, and build frequency with what was with the news. Because my category is not top of the mind recall. I want to be throughout the year present. I'm not like a Pepsi Coke for that matter. So I have to find a, neither we have a budgets like that. So we typically rely on these news to keep yourself alive for the next 6-7 months. Now, if the quality of content there, you're forced to move on to other channels, but digital is paving the way. But imagery part, I think TV still continue to hold a lot of momentum there.
Okay. 5 years, I don't know whether the definition of OTT, where you have hot stars of the world, and television, will it be different? I don't think so. People are consuming television content on the phone. So this discussion today, maybe if all of us are still working till then, and we are again here after 5 years, will we be discussing television or will we be talking more of audiovisual? Okay. You have Google TV also now and you have Apple TV. So I don't think it'll be right to say what will happen in 5 years. I think, as you rightly said, content has to evolve, and audience, the way audience evolves, the medium will evolve.
Maybe we'll be discussing a new definition of television by then. Television viewing would have.
So, just as my fellow panelists said, I think as marketers, what's important is getting the message across. Maybe the support that we can get as mediums evolve going forward, if there are ways that we can measure them better and use them more effectively to demonstrate the ROMI that we need to demonstrate, I think that will shift. My personal view is that as far as India is concerned, TV is not going anywhere and TV advertising is not going anywhere. I remember when we were discussing this at office, someone mentioned to me that a lot of people in the room don't actually have televisions in their house, the younger crowd. That struck me then as a big insight. But in reality, my consumers are not them.
Yeah.
We tend to get very metro-centric as far as these views are concerned, but actually, on the other side of it, when we run schemes in wholesale, we've tended to give, our best price was a TV. You know, you get a TV or you get a bike. Now the dealers are fed up with TV. They say, we don't want TV. Give us an Alexa, for instance. So, I think there is a lot of TVs that are there. And there will be more TVs that will come. And as long as that's there, I think marketers like us will continue to spend over there to get our marketing messages across.
So, we are exactly 2 minutes away. And, sorry? Yeah, we're pretty good at time, but this started 10 minutes after we started the panel. I noticed that also. So, I think it's fair to conclude that TV will be there for another 10, 15 years in India, particularly. And we'll keep definition will change. So on that note, we can close this session and you guys can head for lunch.